Welcome to Anything But. I'm here today at Gower Street with Sri Lanka's celebrated, award-winning, well-known filmmaker, woman filmmaker, Sumitra Peries. Mrs. Peries, I've been talking to you for years, and here we are again talking all over again.
My God, it's almost as though we've been born as neighbours, because I've... How long have
it's
we known?
It's been 30, 35 years, down to today. Now, we are in this house, the house where you grew up at Gower Street. But what was your childhood like in Avisarella?
I think my rural childhood, as it were, I think it's still nostalgic for me, because I still love nature, I love the greenery, I love what is natural. So as a result, even when I'm looking back, I look back more at Avisarella than even at this house. But even this house to me is very special, because when we were in Avisarella, it was too far, so my parents brought us and left us in the hostel. My sister had been in the hostel during the war. But I, because of the war, I think I was a late entrant to Visakhapatnam. And I was in the hostel, and we never thought, watching the people in this house, that we'll be the owners of this. So my mother, who was ill, was determined that she should spend years, she didn't think it was the last year, with her children. So she bought this house to send us to school.
So right behind me actually is the Visakha Vidyalaya hostel, where Mrs. Peries and her sister Lata had been just behind me here for years. And then they came as neighbours, and you jumped across the wall to go to school, right?
Yes, we used to wait till the bell, first bell, and then drinking the milk or the water, we used to run and jump over the wall. The walls were not this high at that time.
I mean, they're 10-foot walls or whatever now.
Yes, things are different, you know, in the 40s. I think this house was bought by my mother in 1949. Actually, it was bought by my mother and my mother's brother. So we were cousins, and us, seven or eight of us, young people in this house. That was a glorious time.
You go back many, many years. And the Nal, the Aralia trees down the lane here, which lead to the house, also been planted by young Sumitra Gunavardhana. Now, basically, back again to Avisarella. If you were to go back and relive your childhood, what would you want to relive?
I think I'm surprised that I didn't take a political line, because the atmosphere at home was politics.
The Borulugoda clan.
Borulugoda clan meetings, an emperor coming with to look after the malaria people in Ratnapura, Ruangwala.
So why didn't you?
That's
lots of your family.
I was too small. I think I was a bit. Vivian Gunawardhana, who's my cousin, she would have been 20 years older than us. So she would have been with the uncles. I would have been a tiny tot, you know, just being carried maybe by them. So it's a... And also, basically, I think I'm a quiet, shyer person. I may not have liked to have... Though I have exposed myself to the public with cinema, but that is hiding behind... But it's possibly myself who's speaking. But as opposed to somebody who is up on a platform and pontificates about life, I wasn't that sure what life has should hold for anybody, for that matter. So I was questioning, and I was a child who was, I think, very concerned about life itself, though. At that time, when I was young, I just thought we'll do science, because everybody thought if you are a bit smart, you should do science. I mean, it's just that you want to show that you are a bit smart, not that you like science. But that in itself, I think, gave a kind of backup for you.
And are you conscious of the fact that you are a member of the Borulugoda clan? Maybe it's a wrong question, but still, let's get to the answer.
I think I'm proud to be a part of that social history, because as somebody said, life is of, sometimes you look at history, history is a list of biographies of different people. So the way people have lived, you know, you can't get the whole masses as to how they built Rangwali Sahaya. There may be one king who gets or whatever it is brought into focus. It's the same with the film. I mean, there are a whole lot of us get together and make this film, and then the director is highlighted. But actually, it is the director, because the same teams work with different directors and they don't come up with the same product.
So, now, back to Visakha Vidyalaya, what would be your best memory here? Your old school, your neighbor, right behind us here.
Actually, memory-wise, funny, with all the things that one can remember, I still remember being junior under-14 champion. Actually, it was a tie with the smartest running person in school. But I tagged on to her and, you know, having the three-legged race and got her energy. Somehow, I shared that cup with her. And first time I ever saw myself in the press was a photograph of me like an Amazonian lady throwing. I must have been 13. And then the fact that that was, I don't know how it remained in my papers or something. And it's there even in present day books sometimes. So I felt, it seems, I didn't continue with sports. Just I played badminton and I played netball and all that at a particular time.
You are a very bad cook, aren't you? Not bad, but not a very good cook, okay?
I'm a good connoisseur of food.
You're an epicurean. You enjoy the food wine.
But when it comes to the kitchen wine, department. I enjoy food, but unfortunately, what I imagine should be the test, I can't seem to arrive at.
So are you making it?
I'm making it. Either it will get overburnt or oversalted, or somehow kitchen does not invite me. So, which is sad, but that's how, I think even when we were young, my sister, in the same house, my sister used to be going for cookery classes and making fancy food, and there was and even my brother, who was older than me, he was a super cook. I mean, at that time, he used to make mayonnaise and all that. So I still remember he was saying, oh, the temperature of the olive oil and the egg has to, how it has to match so that it doesn't curdle, and he used to make excellent mayonnaise. So even in the year dot, I mean, when things were not that fashionable. So in the same house, in the same kitchen, we used to cook. She used to cook. And she used to sometimes banish us because we used to taste food and not cook, you know. So cooking was there, but somehow the womanly thing that I might have taken to was possibly...
What is womanly in you?
Womanly thing would have been mostly maybe sewing, you know. I was not bad at sewing. My sister again went to the
Kathleen school.
I didn't go, but I could work out how to cut a jacket or to mark a jacket or to do the workings of that, the mathematical workings. And I was good at that. So I can't say that I was anti, you know, I was not feminine in that sense of the word, but I was feminine in, so, but cooking is, now they believe that cooking is, has no gender, no, my, I mean, all the chefs
in the best hotels. So is hairdressing.
Yeah, so it's universal, and certain people are gifted for certain things, and I think I like gardening yet, except that physical garden.
You've got a beautiful garden.
Even my niece has a super garden. She's totally committed. But as you know, it's not easy to maintain gardens. And today, people are not available readily. So in a way, I wish I can tell a cook how to cook something.
But you can't do it yourself.
I can't do it. If I try to do it myself, I mess.
On that gastronomic note, we bring Sequence X to a close in the beautiful garden here at Gower Street, where Mrs. Peries grew up as a little girl. And we next move on to a sequence. Why we talk about Sumitra Peries, the filmmaker.